In this video, you're going to learn how to take your Insta360 videos from dull to cinematic using free features that only take a few seconds to use. I've been color grading for 20 years for every type of video project imaginable, so I can tell you exactly which settings matter when it comes to color grading and which ones you can completely forget. So in this video, I'll show you three different techniques for getting cinematic colors from your Insta360 shots, starting at the simplest and going all the way through to the most advanced. Then once you've seen all three methods, you can choose which one works best for you. Okay, so firstly, it doesn't matter which Insta360 camera you're using, whether it's the latest X5 or something else, and it also doesn't matter which color profile you shot with. Since most Insta360 cameras offer standard, log, and vivid, which are three different options that give you a different look straight out of the camera. However, you can still get the same cinematic results regardless of the method you shot with. I will cover these settings in more detail in an upcoming video. Now, the first and easiest color grading method is using my free Insta360 Cinematic LUT pack. And what a LUT is basically a drag and drop file that instantly applies a color grade to a clip without having to touch any of the scary looking color settings. So if you're a beginner and want to stay well away from anything complicated, I'd recommend this workflow. So inside my free LUT pack, which you can download below, I've included five different types of color grade that you can use for a wide range of use cases, including hyperlapse shots like this one, exterior shots where you want to bring down the highlights and bring up the shadows, especially if you've got faces in shot, and it will also get the colors looking nice and vibrant. There's a LUT for interiors to help you brighten up your interior shots so everything is really clear and your highlights also aren't overblown. There's one for shooting at night if you are in a really dark space and you want to bring up the shadows while still keeping your shot natural looking and free of grain. Finally, there's a HDR option if you are shooting in active HDR, which most Insta360 cameras have. This LUT will bring back a bit of the contrast that was lost while also boosting the colors. Again, I'm not charging for these. You can download them completely for free by following the link below. So here I am inside DaVinci Resolve, which is my video editor of choice right now, since it is 100% free to use and it's a very advanced and capable editor. So if you do plan on editing your videos yourself, I would definitely recommend it. Now, to install these LUTs, so it's literally one click to apply them for your Insta360 videos, you'll want to head down to the settings wheel at the bottom right and click it. Then under the color management menu, here under lookup tables, which is what LUT stands for, click open LUT folder. This is now pointing us to the location where all of our color presets can be found within DaVinci Resolve. So anytime you want to add a new one, you'll want to drag and drop it into here. So now it's just a matter of copying over my cinematic LUT pack by using Command or Control C to copy, then heading back to the DaVinci folder and hitting Command or Control V to paste it. Once that's done, back here in DaVinci, you'll want to click Update Lists and then save. Now when we head to the Color tab in DaVinci, here at the top left under LUTs, you'll see the Ben Claremont Insta360 Cinematic LUT pack where you can find all five LUTs. To add one, just right click and apply LUT to current node. So once you've installed the LUT pack the first time, you won't have to do it ever again. And it's just a matter of repeating the process I just showed you when you're editing in Resolve by right clicking and apply LUT to current node. Again, if you want to download my Insta360 Cinematic LUT pack, you can do so for free by following the link below. The next method for color correction is doing it right here in Insta360 Studio, which is the free software by Insta360, which is usually used to stitch and reframe shots. However, here on the right hand side, under Media Processing, you'll find an entire color correction menu. And color grading here is going to be the best option for anyone who wants to avoid getting their hands dirty with a video editing software, learning all the intricacies of editing and so on. And you just want a simple way to add basic color correction to your shots. Okay, so I've got my shot here that was taken on the Insta360 X5, which looks pretty good, but I can see it definitely needs some color grading. And the simplest way to do that here in Insta360 Studio is selecting Color Plus, which is Insta360's automatic color correction setting. Now with any slider, if you want to see exactly what it does, the best way to do it is by dragging the slider all the way up. So if we do that here with Color Plus, you'll see that it attempts to increase the dynamic range as well as a bit of contrast and clarity. So clearly if I drag it all the way up to 100%, it's serious overkill. However, if you drag it down to around 30, which was its starting number, this is a very decent basic color correction. However, we can definitely do better by doing it ourselves. There is also Clarity Plus here, which focuses on sharpening out shots. If your shot is really blurry for whatever reason, this is an okay setting to use to sharpen it up, but it's probably going to look a little bit over sharpened. So again, I just think we can get better results by doing it ourselves manually, which really isn't hard. So here under Adjust, this is where we can find all the different settings that will change both the color and exposure of this shot. Because color grading really is a personal thing. Some people like really colorful shots, some people like them more muted, and there really is so many different ways you can color grade your shots. So I'll show you how I do it here. However, of course, you'll want to tailor these adjustments to your personal taste. Okay, so there are four main sliders associated with color: saturation, vibrance, temperature, and tint. And the biggest mistake beginners usually make is going straight to the saturation slider, since this basically turns up all colors evenly. As you can see, it made the sky bluer, but it also made my face really orange, and I'm not really a fan of the Ronald McDonald look, so I don't think I'm going to be using that. When there is an option like vibrance, and what vibrance does is it turns up only the colors that have low saturation, and it leaves the colors that are already well saturated. So as you'll see, I'm going to drag this all the way to the right. And look at that, the sky is a lot bluer, however my skin tone still remained relatively the same, creating a much more natural looking shot. Fantastic. Next is temperature, which refers to how warm or cool the shot is. So again, I like to just go a bit to the right and left to see what looks good. Usually the temperature is going to look natural somewhere around zero or slightly to the left, especially if you're shooting outside with lots of sun. So I'm pretty happy with this at -2. However, if you're not sure, you'll definitely want to leave this on zero. Then there's tint, which is green magenta for when you're shooting indoors under overhead lights, which can sometimes cast a bit of magenta or green. So this is basically there to correct that. So I'll leave that one. All right, so I've turned my vibrance way up and that looks good, at least for now. Next, I'm going to move on to the exposure sliders, which are these ones up here. But don't worry, we're not going to use every single slider. We're going to use as few as we can get away with. And I always start by dragging the shadow slider to the right to bring up shadows. As you can see, that's really brought up the detail on my face, making it a lot more visible. So I'm just going to move that around until I'm happy with it. I think around there looks good. Next is highlights. I can see I've got the sun in shot here, which has already got pretty good dynamic range, so there's not a lot to do. So I'll try dragging the highlights down a bit and see what happens. Not much. However, if your shot is really overexposed and there's a lot of white in the sky, this is when you want to be a bit more aggressive with the highlights slider. Now, I'm not going to touch this exposure slider here since my exposure is looking pretty good already. The camera has a really intelligent auto exposure mode, so it basically gets the exposure level right while you're shooting, hence you shouldn't need to change this later on. Now it's time to watch this clip back and see how it looks. So let's take a look, and that is really good. I honestly don't have any changes I'd make. That is graded practically perfectly, if I do say so myself. And it's always important to look at the before and after effects just so you can see if your color grading really did make much of a difference or not. So here next to adjust, I'm just going to toggle this off and on to see the before and after. There's before, after, before, after. So we've definitely made a significant improvement to this video. Now, if you're following along at home, one thing I want you to avoid doing is copying my sliders exactly, since with this type of shot, I have a very specific lighting setup where the sun is on an angle here, there is like light cloud cover over Sydney Harbour, and pretty harsh contrasting light on my face. But your shot might look completely different to mine, especially if you live in England. If that's the case, it's going to be grey and desaturated and depressing, in which case you would use a different combination of these sliders. Here's an example for my British friends. So this shot does look a little bit dark, so I'm going to color grade this in a different way. So I'll start by bringing the shadows up and back a little bit. The exposure is going to go up just a little bit, and the highlights down to bring back the cloud detail. Vibrance is going to go up, and maybe the temperature is going to change just a little bit to make it look more neutral. So there we go. We've got sliders that look completely different to before. However, as you can see, this has enhanced this image substantially and made it actually look like an inviting day. The only other one to point out down here is definition, and this is obviously sharpening. So if I drag that one across, you'll see it digitally sharpens the image, and I'd never recommend using this much. If you do, just use it a little bit if you feel like your shot does look a bit soft. So now it looks a little bit more defined. Now, one thing I want to point out at the bottom of this color correction menu is this button here that says batch settings. And what this does is it basically allows us to apply all of the color correction adjustments that we just made to multiple other clips. So if you captured multiple clips at the same location with similar lighting, chances are that the color grade is going to look the same, in which case you can keep all of the options ticked and then click next. Now we're going to choose the other clips we want to apply it to. So under camera files, here are my other clips. So I'm going to find the other ones that were taken at the same location. I think it was probably this, this, and this. Now I'll click apply in batches. So now when I go to those other clips, you'll see the same color correction has been applied, with the same color adjustments here on the right-hand side. Now, everything I just showed you in Insta360 Studio can also be found in the Insta360 mobile app in a slightly more limited capacity, since you can't quite do as much on mobile as you can do on desktop, which is why I'd recommend using the desktop software if you can, since you're going to get much higher quality shots with better colors through using the more powerful desktop software, which has the full computer behind it, as opposed to your phone, which is a lot more limited in terms of its processing ability. Now, the third and final way to achieve cinematic color grading with your Insta360 shots is here in DaVinci Resolve. So let's say you've downloaded my cinematic LUT pack and you've tried a few out, but you have a situation where the lighting might be quite a bit different, or you're going for a slightly different look to one of these LUTs. Well, this is where you'd color correct your shots manually. And here on the color page, there is a crazy amount of options, so try your best not to be overwhelmed by it. But I generally keep things pretty simple. So if I were to color correct this shot manually, I'd drag up the shadows like so. I'd bring down the highlights a little bit, as well as boosting the colors and just tweaking the temperature a little bit. So that shot looks pretty awesome. And there's another entire 10-hour video around color correcting in DaVinci Resolve, which I won't bore you with right now. However, I'll just say that DaVinci Resolve is the most powerful and advanced color correction software there is, and not to mention it's completely free and you can edit your entire video inside of it. I do have a couple of videos on my channel that will teach you DaVinci Resolve if you're curious. So usually I will manually color correct shots when I feel the need to enhance just one or two in a different way. However, for the majority of Insta360 shots, the cinematic LUT pack really should do the trick. Again, you can download 100% for free below. Now, if you are interested in using DaVinci Resolve here for editing and or color correction, in this video here, you'll find my beginner's guide to color correction using only the most basic simple sliders here within DaVinci that will transform your videos from okay to amazing.